welcome to another edition of Black
and Blue.
And I am Pastor Aaron.
And I'm Deaconess Micah.
And today's episode we have coined Woo
Not Boo.
Woo Not Boo. Soon enough, you'll be picking up what we are putting down, right?
Mm-hmm.
So yes. Let's begin here, Deaconess, okay? Let's just get right to it. How do we normally, generally respond to ideas, a way of life, or something we see on Facebook that is contrary to God's word?
Boo! No! Bad! Don't like! Dislike! Ah!
Angry emoji.
Mm-hmm.
Tasmanian devil. Brah!
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. This is going down.
Yeah, we're gonna coin this person the furious follower.
Mm-hmm.
And the furious follower is all about the business of boo, boo, mm-hmm. boo. The furious follower mm-hmm. is all about thinking I'm right, that person's wrong. Mm-hmm. And the whole point now for that furious follower is to do what?
Win the argument. The other person's going down. I'm going to go up. I'm going to win. Defeat them. Win the game. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Be right.
They are prideful. Oh. I mean, what letter is in the middle of pride? I forget.
I.
It's all about me, myself, and I.
Mm-hmm.
I want to talk about me. I want to talk about I. I want to talk about me.
Number one.
Oh, my. There we go. I needed my backup here. Thank you, Deaconess.
You're welcome.
Oh, man, you came through for me again.
Yes.
So the furious follower is prideful mm-hmm. and sees himself, herself as right and the mm-hmm. other people as wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And now they are the adversary. They are the mm-hmm. enemy. They must be mm-hmm. destroyed, annihilated. Mm-hmm. They must really just be defeated.
Mm-hmm. Silenced.
Boo! Mm-hmm. Boo! Mm-hmm. Using that boo to silence them, right?
Exactly.
Is there a better way?
There is.
Oh.
There is.
What is the better way?
It is the curious Christian
the
way.
The curious Christian way? Oh, man. And that's not about booing, but about
wooing.
Not about booing, but mm-hmm. about wooing.
Mm-hmm.
And really, the curious Christian, this is the Christian... like yourself and like us, where, you know, we see ourselves and everyone in the same boat.
Mm-hmm.
A poor, miserable sinner boat. Mm-hmm. The furious follower, it's all about us versus them. Mm-hmm. But for the curious Christian, we realize we're, you know, there's only us.
Exactly.
Poor, miserable sinners.
Mm-hmm.
And I like to think about the parable of the publican mm-hmm. and the tax collector, right?
Mm-hmm. And, or the Pharisee.
Or the Pharisee, yeah, mm-hmm. sure. Yeah, I went old school there.
Uh-huh.
Again, you know, all these gray hairs. Showing my age here.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, the publican, the Pharisee, and the tax collector.
Uh-huh.
And how does that parable go, dear Deaconess? Do you remember in Luke's gospel?
Mm-hmm. I mean, there's... two people in the temple, the tax collector and the Pharisee. And the Pharisee is standing up and thanking God that, you know, that he's not like that sinner,
that tax collector.
He tithes, he has everything together and does everything right, but not like that tax collector.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, that tax collector...
can't even look up to heaven.
Exactly.
Beats his breast
mm-hmm.
and his chest, and he says, God be merciful to me, a sinner. Actually, in the Greek, the definite mm-hmm. article is used there.
Mm-hmm.
God be merciful to me, the sinner. I find that very important because really, and he out of all the people in the world, he sees himself as the sinner.
Yes.
First and mm-hmm. foremost, he sees his own sin, his mm-hmm. own failings, his own flailings, his own mm-hmm. flops, right?
Mm-hmm.
He sees his own sin.
Yes.
And that humbles him,
mm-hmm.
right? And we know from Luke's gospel, the humble are...
Exalted,
yeah.
Raised
so
up.
So the tax collector goes home justified,
mm-hmm.
Declared righteous.
Mm-hmm.
Enough! You know, God says, he's enough!
Mm-hmm.
Not because of anything in him, right? But his faith takes hold of the God who... Mm-hmm. declares sinners righteous enough. And so this man goes into his town seeing everyone really as the same as he is,
mm-hmm.
a poor, miserable sinner. There's
mm-hmm.
no comparisons game to play.
Right.
There's really nothing to win.
Exactly.
Because actually the victory has already been won, mm-hmm. right?
By the one who humbled himself by obedience unto death, even death on a cross.
Oh, exactly. Jesus?
Yeah.
Yes. He's the one that won the victory. He's the one from mm-hmm. the cross that said, you know, it is enough, mm-hmm. right? That he is enough.
Yes.
His death, mm-hmm. victory over sin, victory over death, victory over big bad wolf, Satan. Mm-hmm. And so the victory's already been won. We don't have to go around living like, you know, there's some victory to win here.
Mm-hmm. I've got to go fight a battle.
Yeah, no. Not at all. So this actually puts us in a posture mm-hmm. of humility and you know, just ease and comfort. Mm-hmm. And we can just rest in the victory of Jesus mm-hmm. and we can ask questions.
Yeah.
You know, can you tell me more about that? Like, you know, when confronted with ideas that, mm-hmm. that just, mm-hmm. you know, you've never heard before, or you know, they go against scripture. Mm-hmm. You can ask questions.
Mm-hmm. What do you mean by that?
Yeah. Because you know, this person's not your enemy. There's only one enemy. Mm-hmm. His name is Satan.
Yep.
No human being on the face mm-hmm. of planet Earth, your enemy. Mm-hmm. The only enemy we have is Satan, right? His skull has been crushed, right? On mm-hmm. the Friday we call good. So we mm-hmm. can just, you know, be patient with everyone mm-hmm. and ask questions.
Yes.
Yeah, tell me more about that. Yeah. Well, I've never really heard that before. Can you explain where you're coming from? Mm-hmm. And, you know, we have a God who asks questions.
Yes, he does.
I mean, I think about the fall into sin, right? Mm-hmm. What happened there, Deaconess?
Yeah. I mean, we find out that our Lord is walking in the garden and he says, "Where are you?"
Where are you?
To Adam.
Where are you? Yeah, a question.
Yeah, he knows where Adam and Eve are hiding with their fig clothes.
He knows everything.
Yeah.
And then I think of like Jesus, like in the Gospel of John. I mean, the first words out of his mouth in the Gospel mm-hmm. of John, a question. Mm-hmm. What are you seeking? Mm-hmm. The first words out of his mouth after the resurrection, a question exactly. to Mary Magdalene, right? Mm-hmm. Who are you seeking? Right? Amazing. And then, you know, road to Emmaus, mm-hmm. Luke 24, right?
Yes.
You have Cleopas and the unnamed disciple. You know, mm-hmm. Jesus knows what happened on the Friday we call good.
He was kind of there.
He was kind of part of it. And you know, we have listed here a bunch of questions that he asked them. What is this conversation that you're holding with each mm-hmm. other as you walk?
Yeah.
And then he asked another question, what things? Mm-hmm. And then another question, was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory? Mm-hmm. You know, the God who knows all, asking questions. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So how much more?
Us and you.
We'd ask questions, yeah.
Yep.
Because, I mean, we don't have all our ducks in a row, okay? Mm-hmm. We see it through a glass dimly, as mm-hmm. Pastor Paul tells us. And so we, as the curious Christians, there's no reason for us to be prideful. Mm-hmm. What we are called to be is prayerful. Mm-hmm. So not furious, but curious. Not prideful, but prayerful. And you know, when we are confronted by ideas and a way of life that really just contradicts God's word, his law, mm-hmm. The Bible, mm-hmm. We don't have to judge. No judgy. We have the opportunity to pray for these people and go to the Father in heaven for the mm-hmm. very things that they lack. Mm-hmm. And so a good example would be mm-hmm. from Luke's gospel.
Right. With the grumpy next door neighbor.
From what chapter?
Oh, that's Luke chapter 11, right after the Lord's Prayer, after Jesus teaches his disciples how to pray. And mm-hmm. there's this unexpected guest who comes at midnight, and you can't go to the store to go get anything, and the cupboards are empty, so what do? Mm-hmm. You go to your next door neighbor and pound on his door, going, "Hey, I need some bread. I need some food for my guest."
And a cake from Costco, because I love cake from Costco.
He does.
I actually don't like cake. I mean, for our wedding, I mean, Ruth and I, we had actually Butterhorns, which mm-hmm. is like a Frankenmuth favorite. We had no wedding cake. That's how much I don't like cake. Uh-huh. No cake at my wedding. So Costco cake. We had to get the Costco cake from the next door neighbor.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Exactly. Very good. Yes.
So anyway, back on mm-hmm. track.
Back on track.
I am track that.
There you go. And so then he just asks this neighbor for all that he needs, and he's persistent. till finally, after the 500th knock on that door, the grumpy neighbor finally gets up and brings out the bread and the Costco cake, everything that's needed for that
and the
guest.
Ham and the mayo.
And his little dog,
too. Better be Hellman's.
We're finding out all about your family.
Yeah, really.
Foods.
I mean, we're learning all about Pastor A around here. So like we go to our next door neighbor for patience, for the right words,
For the Holy Spirit,
eyes open for this person. They would see the truth. Mm-hmm. That they would see what God's word says, and be repented if there's a sin, especially, and receive forgiveness of sins and be set free to live and move and have their being in the freedom of the gospel.
And isn't it awesome that the pressure's not on
us? It's not on us.
Yeah.
I mean, just like Road to Emmaus, right? I mean, who's opening eyes? Not me, not you.
It's Jesus.
Always. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's why we want to stay in conversation so that we have those opportunities to share the truth, because we know the Holy Spirit works through the truth and will lead people into all truth. Mm-hmm. Just closing the door in people's faces, burning bridges, that's not really that helpful.
Nope,
that is the furious follower's way. Mm-hmm. The curious Christian, we keep the door open. Mm-hmm. And I know sometimes it can be very uncomfortable, but we know that a person is brought to faith, not in our time, but in God's time. Mm-hmm. It's his work. Mm-hmm. Yep, and he uses us, praise be to God. But the pressure is off of us.
Yep.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And so instead of seeing, people as adversaries, we want to see ourselves as advocates, right? Mm-hmm. Because we have advocates, plural.
Right.
Right.
We have an advocate with the Father. Jesus is the propitiation for our sins. And then what's the Holy Spirit called in the Gospel of John?
An advocate.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And so I always like to picture, we have these two advocates who bring us to the Father, one for our left arm and one for our right arm, and brings us, to the throne of grace, into the Father's, mansion, into the living room. We get to climb up into his lap, and we get to pray to our Father in heaven. Mm-hmm. And so we can, copycat, the advocates.
Yes.
By coming alongside, that's what the word advocate means, right? Paraclete, called alongside one. We get to come alongside a person, and we get to instead of like, being face-to-face, like being in this adversarial kind of posture, we get to come alongside the person and be in that advocate posture.
Walk alongside however long the journey goes. I mean, it could be miles and miles.
Yeah, we have to meet people where they're at, baby steps.
Yeah.
I think about my own growth as a Christian. It's like, wow, where I was 10 years ago or even 20 years ago, I mean, there's growth every year. Mm-hmm. So you can't expect someone to get where you are today in one conversation.
Yep.
It's not going to happen. Mm-hmm. I mean, maybe, I guess you could have some road to Damascus experience, that you witnessed with this person, but probably not going
to
happen.
And again, road to Damascus isn't on us either. it's on our Lord Jesus. Yeah. So regardless, it's always in his hands, and his word never returns empty. Yeah. We get to rest in that, which is amazing.
Yeah,
rest in that as we walk next to the people that our Lord has called us to walk alongside, whether friends or relatives, classmates, fellow church members of your youth group. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So curious, not
furious,
prayerful, not
prideful.
Woo.
Not boo.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, which will we be? The adversary or the advocate? And I reckon our Lord calls us to be the advocate, right?
Yep.
And what a joy to be an advocate. Mm-hmm. We're copycatting the advocates, the Son and the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. And we're doing this with the goal that eyes would be opened.
Yes.
And people would see Jesus as Savior of the world, their Savior.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What a joy to be part of the work that Jesus has in this world.
We get to follow in his train. Woohoo! Yeah.
So woo?
Not boo.
There's a lot of joy in that. There is. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There is.
Yeah. Well, by his wounds,
we are healed.
Until next time.
See you later.
Bye-bye, Toodles.
Toodles.